It's true, I crave you.
What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is T-Bagger Gibbon. It is Friday. We are in the realms of about having some fun. I can't even talk. Right, I have today for you a... I'm just going to turn this down just quickly before we get started. I have for you a new game. I got it off of Steam. It is a ridiculously cheap game. I think it was only about £7 or something like that. The game is actually called The Park. It's a psychological horror type game. I think, roughly speaking, there's only about 2 hours worth of gameplay altogether, but I thought it would be a decent one to just to start to bring me doing gameplays back again. It's been a little while. I had made starts on some other games, but I couldn't get into them. Game of Thrones I was struggling with. I might go back to Tales from the Borderland. I need to give that a bit of a thought if I'm going to do that. But yeah, this is supposed to be shit scary. It's supposed to be really, really good. So I will give it a try. I think it's quite heavily story orientated. There's probably quite a few cutscenes. So usual thing. I will try not to talk too much through the cutscenes. I may scream like a little girl. So yeah, fuck it. Let's get into it, guys. I hope you enjoy it. Let's see where we can see what we can do. Here we go. Right, best turn this back up. Park is a narrative experience by spending a dark room wearing headphones. It deals with subject matter that may be disturbing to some players. During the course of play, the park may manipulate graphics, audio, control settings, and your sanity. This is perfectly normal. Should not be any cause for alarm or a sore psychiatry. Ooh, here we go. Right. I'll tell you what I am going to do. Let me know what you all think of the... cha-ching. Lit up headphones. Anyways, I hope everybody's had a good week. My week has been hard, to say the least. It's been busy. Anyway, so, like I say, I'm going to give this a go. So, Funcom, that's the company. I think it's an Australian company that did this.
I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum.
Nice tattoo. Jesus, how high are those jeans?
Stay in the car. I'll go and ask information.
Now, I've got the setting set on ultra. Oh, Jesus. Right, I've got the setting set on ultra, so I need to see how it's going to run on that. But I'm... Right. So I'm guessing I'm going to the park. Oh wow, this seems... Look how... This looks beautiful. See birds flying. This game is gonna... Oh, what's this? Atlantic Island Park. Drink bingo. How do you drink bingo? Right, okay. Let's go.
Attention, patrons. The park is now closed.
Okay.
Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience.
I'm at the car park. I've lost some bits and pieces. That's what I'm struggling with. Press to interact with objects in the world. There's nothing to interact with. Oh, I just need to turn that screen off. Alright, okay. Oh. Right. Let's walk, so... Okay, so what... Oh, examine plaque. What? I just...
Callum was born the day this place opened. This is his favorite place in the world.
Tribute to the untamed heart of Solomon Island and the people who use their talents to bring the dream of Nathaniel Winter to life. May this park be a place where joy and laughter are gathered and used to infect all of those who follow after. I don't like some of the wording in that. Infect. Right, okay, so... right, that... Oh, right, okay, I need to go speak to this guy. I need to go speak to information. I need to find that teddy bear. Oh, here we go. Cutscene. Shh.
What?
What? Hey, Lorraine. Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop! think your boy just ran into the park.
Oh, I've already got...
I'll unlock the gates for you.
I've got chills already. Oh, this is going to freak me out. I can feel it already. Right, let's see. Okay, so I need to go through that bit. Okay. Press to shout Callum. Shouting provides audible and visual clues to guide you.
Callum, where are you going?
Over here.
Okay. Already, I am not... I already don't like this. We've not even started properly yet. I'm a walk
There's
up.
Something special about the entrance. Oh, there he is. Amusement park.
Sup, Callum? Where are you going?
Line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives, and on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed.
You serious? This looks it looks rusty as fuck, and he's disappearing. Oh. 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 What the fuck? And we're off already. Okay, here we go. I'm not good with scary games. If you'd watched my Outlast series, that messed me up quite a lot. Okay. Okay. Why is there so much bass on that? Can I get through here?
Oh God. The park. What happened here?
Press shift to toggle running. Okay. Okay. Oh. What was that? Is it? Can I? No. Yo, this looks... Oh, fuck. It's going to be one of these types of games. Right. Right. So he went... Do I need to run up? Do I have to run after him? Or should I look at this? That's just a map. Right. Okay. So, little man ran down here. Should I shout him? Yeah, I'll shout. What? That is the freakiest looking thing in the world.
Wait, Callum.
Oh, this is gonna see things with kids in. I don't like because kids are. Whoa! Why is it going weird? Can I go in here? I don't know what. Is he hiding? No. Can I go in? I'm already shitting myself. This is ridiculous. I'm a grown ass man. Can I go in here? Can I go? Can I?
Too dark. I'm not going in there without a flashlight.
Right, okay, so I need to find some sort of flashlight then, apparently. Come on, run, 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 run. Okay. Well, I think that little entrance is going to play a part. There's lots of saving going on at the moment, which worries me. Okay. Oh! Is that birds or bats or what? Okie dokie. Wishing well, I'm thinking. What shoe? Oh, there's a shoe.
I think this belongs to Callum.
So Callum's lost his shoe. It's a good start. Put it... Oh. Okay. Let's have a look at the plaque. What's... That's a light. Let's have a look at the plaque.
Chad the Chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit.
Chad the Chipmunk welcomes you to Atlantic Island Park. Chad can be seen in daily ice sculpting shows in the following locations. At 11 a.m. Sideshow Alley. 1 p.m. Octotron? Is that a word? Okay. Or 3 p.m. park entrance. And there's a little bit on the side here which I think I'm probably going to have to pay attention to. Chad the Chipmunk, worst in class. Chad can't even seem to pass. Chad gets angry, likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead-end job. Chad will die a useless slob. Well, that's a bit fucking... Yeah. Okay. Okay. Right, I'm going to keep going. What's that? Well, these are toilets. Can I... Can I go in? No. What was that? Read handwritten note. Okay.
What's this?
Purchase the land or Solomon Island for the pittance. I might add. Whoever old Archie Henderson... What the hell is that I can hear? Right, that sounds fucked up. Whatever old Archie Henderson did to the locals, just the mention of his name had people slamming doors and locking shutters from the moment I arrived on the island. My lawyers had arranged everything in advance, but the realtor still had to come and deliver the keys to me personally. He took it upon himself to offer me another warning. That voice is really freaky. Another warning. I don't know what you're planning to do with this land, Mr. Winter, but the soil here is bitter with a curse carried from the old country. Old man Henderson, he did terrible dark things to the land. The land remembers, sir. Okay. I dismissed him shortly afterwards, mostly amused by his pathetic attempts at warning me off. I have a great vision for this place and the will to see that vision through to the very end. Atlantic Island Park, the name is perfect and I cannot imagine it being anything else. This is the start of something amazing. Okay. That's fine. Oh shit, glitchy. I'll tell you what I'm going to do actually, just before we crack on. I'm just going to change the settings in video. Right, so I'm trying to make out what this person is saying up here. Whatever it is, it's sinister. Oh, I've just worked out what the toggle running means now. You don't need to hold shift, you just press it. And then you can walk or run around.
Hello?
Over here. Right, okay. So, I guess the idea is that you keep pressing. Who's that? Is that you keep pressing to be able to hear. I'll tell you what I am going to do, actually. Did you all hear that? Really not happy. I'm just going to... What was that? Oh, is that Alan? I can see him. Ooh.
Come on, Mommy.
There we go. Just put a little bit of light on, because I don't know how dark it's going to be. Right, so he's down there wandering around like an absolute... What is that noise? What's this? Tunnel of Tales. Right, so I'm now going to... Are you kidding me? I'm going to have to go on this fucking ride.
Callum, stay where you are.
Where is he? Oh, so he's gone down... What is this on the floor? Right, so he's gone down here then. Okay. Oh, fuck! I don't want to do this. It's going to be ridiculous. I'm going to shit my pants. Oh, here we go. Okay, this isn't sinister at all, and I'm not going to completely crap myself as we're going through this. No, totally not going to crap myself as we're going through. Oh, fuck. Okay, so I can look around. Let's look down. Jeans are a bit ripped, but whatever. Ooh.
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter.
Okay.
His wife and his two children. A boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup.
This is dark.
What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband. We will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow.
Whoa.
And abandon them there. No, my wife. I cannot do that.
Whoa.
Said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep. Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept out of the hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets.
So this is like the Hansel and Gretel story. I don't like this. I can't see anything.
Next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day.
Okay.
Clever Hansel leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they
pass. I need to close my mouth.
When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house.
Okay. Why do I feel like...
After receiving a scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter.
Okay. I feel like I'm being set up.
The mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again.
Whoa, what the fuck?
Hansel broke his bread into pieces.
This isn't good.
A trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed.
So this is where they walk into the witch next, if I remember the Hansel and Gretel story.
Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days.
Why is his voice getting sinister? Why do I feel like I'm... Oh, I don't like this. Someone's going to come out and jump up at me.
The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house.
Oh.
Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls. Little mouse, who is nibbling at my house? An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes. Oh, you dear children, who brought you here?
Not looking forward to this.
Just come in and stay with me. No harm will come to you.
Someone's going to jump out and scare me. I know it is.
For the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you.
Uh-huh.
The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops.
Swear she's going to cook them and eat them.
And began to eat. You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside, the old woman urged. And the children, still licking their sweets, followed.
Uh-huh. Oh, fuck's sake!
Once inside the house, the old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage and put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut.
Okay.
Your brother will make a good mouthful. The old witch told Gretel.
Yeah, because she's going to eat them.
Up, I shall feast upon him.
Oh, bollocks.
Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him.
Okay.
The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven.
Don't climb inside.
I do not know how. Where is the opening? Fool, the old witch said. The opening is here. And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward.
Hold on, Gretel.
Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel.
Okay.
And together they lit a fire beneath the oven.
And burnt the witch!
She screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled and the witch was cooked.
Okay. Is that it?
And then, because even children can't survive on sweets.
Now, why are you going to put fucked up pictures like that? They ate the witch! Why would you put that at the end of a children's story? Oh, he's messed up. So that was that. Oh. Not happy. But why is that? Why is that turned to look at me? Why is that turned to look at me? Okay. So that's a bit messed up. Okay. Right, okay. Can I get out now, please? I'm not going round again. Okay. Okay. So we survived that, so nothing too sinister happened with that. I think it's more just the suggestion of sinister. Okay, so let's run out of there. Let's
go. Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest, the birds, the old witch, even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister, hand in hand against the unkind world. We were always hungry, looking for our own house made of candy.
Still sinister voices coming out of there.
Could take the pain away.
All right, come on.
Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places where the tree branches reach like claws.
Okay, so we're back on it. I'm a run up here because it takes a little while to walk up, but it seems like every one of these that you stop at. It's not started yet. It's an interesting place for a van to be. Oh. Okay.
Another accident. This place.
I don't think it's an accident. Every time it does that, it's making me have chills. Oh. Despite the constant interruptions to work, Atlantic Island Park will be opening on time. The governor is booked to cut the ribbon, so the only real question is whether we will have any customers. I'm not truly worried. Customers will come out of simple curiosity. I deduced what was needed from the banned writings of Archive Henderson. Okay. Fours astonishing to think that a resonance of positive emotions can be used to fuel such a process. Henderson himself chose to use negative, and that caused some of the taint that still lingers in this place. I will not make his mistakes. Very soon, I will know if this has all been for nothing. Okay. So there's a bear in there with a twig in its eye. So I've read the notes. So let's keep going. So up we go. I'm going to shout
for
him.
Where are you?
Why has that just happened? I don't like it when shit like that happens. Okay. So, I'm running to the top. The music's brilliant. The music's really, really well constructed in terms of... Oh, what the... Why? Okay.
Hello?
Well, where is he? I can hear him singing.
Callum, stay where you are.
Is it? Right, I guess I've got to go on this ride then. This isn't going to be good.
This old thing used to make the blood run to my head. It'd make me dizzy. The guy just snapped. Those poor kids.
Eyewitness report, Atlantic Island Park incident, officer on duty, Sheriff Bannerman. Witness name, Creed Norma. Statement, we were waiting for our turn on the ride, Frank, me and the boys. This fellow in the chipmunk suit is making an ice carving while people took photographs. Lawrence wanted to go over to him, but I've always been a bit wary of those suits. They give me the creeps. Feel ya. I don't know what they... I don't. Why did I do that? Should have just gone, feel you. Whatever. Lawrence wanted to go over to him, but I've always been a bit wary of that. Silly, I know. Anyway, the chipmunk man, he was carving and picking away at the eyes. And at first, we thought he was making some animal like a tiger or lion, but as more and more eyes fell away when you first looked, it was like a human face smiling out of that block of ice. But the more you looked at it, the more you saw that there was something not quite right about the proportions. Something unnatural that made your heart begin to beat just a little bit faster. Ba-boom. Ba-boom. Like you were prey and that thing in the ice was a hunter. But then these teenagers walked up and one of them made a face at the carving and said something rude to the guy in the chipmunk suit. And then, well, he went berserk. For a few moments it was chaos. Everybody was running away from the guy who had one of the teenagers on the ground and was stabbing with the ice pick. And you just stood there and watched. And blood was spraying and people were screaming. And Frank and I had the kids and we were dragging them away as fast as we could. And the last thing I saw before Frank dragged me away was that the eyeball of one of those poor kids had landed on the ice sculpture, making the horrible creature look more or less alive. I think this park's pretty fucked up. I say pretty, I just think it's fucked up. Which, right, okay. Can I get that lantern? No, I guess not. So, do I just walk round or do I go on it or what happens?
Where are you?
Where is he? Fuck off with you little...
He's my mommy. He's my mommy.
So do I need to go on the ride or... Okay, we can get in. Saving.
I can't get on while it's moving.
Okay. Increase speed, decrease speed. Alright, let's... decrease speed. So I'm guessing he's going to have some kind of... Is it stopping? I think it's stopping. Do I need to decrease the speed again? Okay. Decrease speed. Okay, it looks like it's stopping. Right, okay, so let's ride it and let's see what happens. Oh, seriously, stop! Is it stopping? Yes, I think... Right, it stopped. That took longer than what I thought it was going to. Okay, so let's ride it. I'm guessing that something else is going to happen on this. But you see, the real question... Why is it speeding up? Who's speeding it up? Who's... Yeah, but who's speeding it up? What? Who was that? I spat on myself. Ugh. Oh, this is going a bit quick. Who sped it up? No, somebody sped it up. What are we doing? Are we stopping? Are we slowing down? I'm not happy about... Oh, shit. It's going to drop me down as we're going past the fucking thing. Who's that in there? Who's that? Who's that? Okay. Who slowed it down? I don't want to ride it again because some weird guy comes out of nowhere and decides that he's going to slow it down. Not happy about that. Really not happy about that. Right. I think what I'm going to do, guys, I think I'm going to leave it for there for that one, just for the introduction. This seems like it's going to be really good. I like these types of games. It looks like it's going to be pretty scary. I don't think it's going to be so much that you're going to see blood and guts, but I think it's more going to be the suggestion of it. So, this will be episode one. And the next episode will come out pretty much either a bit later on today or tomorrow. But I think I can probably pretty much get this done over the weekend. So this should be a short series, hopefully. So thanks for stopping by. If you've enjoyed it, hit the like button. If you are new to my channel, please also subscribe as well. There will be some more Destiny stuff coming. I think we're going to do the hard raid soon. Might do a little bit of Crucible on that. I have got Halo 5 Guardians as well, so I'm thinking about doing a walkthrough for that as well. So yeah, thank you for stopping by, guys. I really appreciate it, and we will more than likely see you on the next one. Thanks again for stopping by. Appreciate it. Peace. It's true, I crave